Our numbers that matter today on state spending. The Philippine government's expenditures last year hit 5.3 trillion pesos. This was higher by 107 billion pesos from the target. The budget department justified the bigger spending on the need to fund more infrastructure projects and other capital outlays. It also attributed government's higher operating expenses to social services-related agencies catching up on spending. In other corporate stories, Globe offers free roaming services to Filipinos in quake-hit Taiwan. Globe postpaid and prepaid customers, as well as TM users currently using roaming services in Taiwan, will get free 15 minutes of incoming and outgoing calls, 15 texts to all networks, and 1 gigabyte data for 7 days at no extra cost. The telco giant says this would help Filipinos in the self-ruled island get in touch with their families and make emergency calls. Cebu Landmasters announces its first international joint venture with Japan's NTTUD. The Vismin property developer is teaming up with a Japanese property firm to develop a 6 billion peso two-tower in Cebu's IT Park. CLI says Tower 1 of its inaugural joint venture project will be launched by the fourth quarter of this year. Earnings now from Filinvest Development Corporation. Its net income attributable to shareholders climbed to 8.9 billion pesos last year. Consolidated net income also higher at 12.1 billion pesos, while revenues and other income were at 92.8 billion. FDC says the higher earnings are due to a double-digit improvement across its business segments. A Senate probe being sought on the supposed gentleman's agreement on the West Philippine Sea between former President Rodrigo Duterte and Chinese leader Xi Jinping. Opposition Senator Risa Ontiveros filed the resolution. Ontiveros called the alleged deal treasonous as it restricted the Philippines from repairing its lone outpost in Ayungan Shoal, the BRP Sierra Madre. The senator adds, if the agreement is true, it would be tantamount to a surrender of Philippine sovereignty. Former Duterte spokesperson Salvador Panelo had denied such a deal was struck, despite it being confirmed by another former Duterte spokesman, Harry Roque. The Philippine Navy proposing 28 forward operating bases, or FOBs, before a Senate panel tackling the proposed Philippine Navy Archipelagic Defensive Act. The bill defines an FOB as a small-scale naval and military facility or outpost where the Philippine Navy can carry out its functions and duties. A 1 billion peso budget has been proposed for 12 possible FOB sites in Palawan, Subic, and Batanes. Panel chairperson Senator Francis Tolentino hopes to pass the bill within the year. Meanwhile, the National Security Council asserts the country will continue its resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre despite China's aggressions. The NSC adds, any new Chinese attempts to foil these missions will be met with a response.